We have got eldest finance minister with us, eldest finance minister in the world, finance guardian in the world. So, we can have a little bit. Honorable chief guest, Mr. Abu Mal Abdul Malik, sir, finance minister of the government of Bangladesh, state minister, sir, and our guardian, Secret Elections Commission's chairman, Professor Dr. Khan, sir. And I can see respected commissioners on the Secret Elections Commission and other dignitaries from the capital market, and my fellow colleagues, assalamu alaikum, and very good evening to you all. In fact, you all must agree with me that our economy is developing gradually. And this development has been possible because of the present government's effective plans, and that plans have been executed in a timely manner. And this development could be proved by seeing so many comments, so many, in fact, treatment given to our economy. Like one very leading merchant bank in the world, JP Morgan, treated us as the frontier five nations in the world. And another, you all know that UK research organization, Investors Chronicle, indicated us as the hottest emerging nation having the high potentials of FDI in the market. You all know it. And then I can cite so many comments. Another, you can see PwC, you all know it, PricewaterhouseCoopers, one of the biggest chartered accountancy firm in the world. They put Bangladesh in their PwC 30 growth countries, seeing the growth potentials in our country. So, in fact, these are good words, good comments they made regarding our economic development. In fact, done by the present government under the leadership of particularly our today's chief guest. And then, other economic factors in our rate, like in 1995, we have our per capita income only $300, and now it is more than $1,300. You are right, and GDP size just 2 decades back was only 1,500 million taka. Now it has crossed 17,000 million taka. And foreign remittance, you all know, 48 billion to now it has crossed 1,200 billion taka. And another indicators I can show you, like in 1995, our forex reserve was only $3 billion. Now it has crossed $30 billion. So in fact, these are the contributions made by me and you to the economic advancement. And in fact, there are some ranking made by various institutions like IMF, Norway. In terms of GDP, we are 44th country in the world, you all know it. And in terms of per capita income, we are 33rd country in the world. And we are the 56th largest economy in the world. And we are not progressing in terms of this sort of economic indicators. We are also progressing in social indicators as well. You have seen in the last week probably that we have become number one in minimizing the gender gap in our society. Excuse me. And another social indicators we have achieved according to World Bank survey. Like World Bank survey shows we have achieved MDG, Millennium Development Goal, of poverty headcount to 28%. it was 57% in the last decade. And we have resources in our economy, like our population, which is 60% of our population belongs to 25 years of age. And another great point for our economic development is our strategic location. We are located in the mid of two giant economies in the sub-region. One is China, you know, another one is India. So this helps in bringing so many India in our country. And you all know, we are in the second position in the South Asian country in ensuring good India in the future. So these are the strength of our economy, economic development. And if we want to develop this economy as a whole, we have no alternative but to develop our capital market. And you all must again agree with me that our capital market is gradually developing, and significant development has been made in the last couple of years under the current commission led by the honorable Professor Dr. Khatib Hussain sir, who has in fact given us the demutualized mortgages, and who has given us this centennial duty of our Securities and Exchange Commission, making this commission as a category one in the book of ISO. And in fact, here I want to put one single comment from the end of the merchant bankers. He, under his humble leadership, he has rescued this capital market from the ashes, from the dump in the debacle of 2010. We should congratulate him because of his dedication, and then his, in fact, thinking forward, establishing good governance in the entire economy, not only in the capital market. He has, in fact, this commission has established good governance in the capital market. They have strengthened the corporate governance guidelines, and for promoting the bond market, they have promulgated the debt security rules in 2015 and amended the listing regulations, public issue rules, etc. Recently, they have promulgated exchange-traded fund, you all know. Exchange-traded fund rule 2016 for stabilizing the secondary market. And they have also going to promulgate the market maker rule, you all know it, which will definitely again help the secondary market. And finally, we see short sale is going to be happened. Short sale is going to be allowed. And I think Commission is thinking for onward establishment of derivative market in our country. A short sale is pre-requirement for having the derivative operations in the country market. And in fact, this capital market is a prime mover for the economic development. And capital market helps industrialization. Capital market contributes heavily to the GDP. And when it said, in our country, capital market to GDP ratio is very minor, which is about 20%. Our capital market is one-fifth of our GDP. And we see this is lowest in the South Asian countries. In India, it is 70%. And you know, in Thailand, it is 93% to my knowledge. And in Malaysia, their capital market is a bit bigger than the GDP. And in Singapore, it is more than double of their GDP. So, seeing these gaps and unsustainable contribution from the capital market to the GDP, we derive to one very strong hypothesis for further study. We have to go miles. We have to develop further by diversity. diversifying our products by establishing good governance in the capital market. And we all know our capital market is fully dependent on equities. Bonds and mutual funds form a very small part of our daily trades. And most of the products comes from the cash segment of the capital market products. We have to diversify it because developing countries' budgets offering diversified products for the capital market. I politely differ with the paper presenter. We have to think as soon as possible for studying the derivative because you all know it, and who does not know it, he will be surprised in knowing it that in India, derivative has been started in this 2000. And within this 16 years time, they have posted 90% of their trade volume from this derivative market. So, if we want to maximize our trade volume, then we have to have this derivative as soon as possible. And I also politely recommend to our Honorable Sir and Honorable Commissioners to think on it for at least they can start this derivative market through a pilot project listing some blue chip company in the derivative market. And I must admit they are also, of course they are working on it because they have issued one circular on the derivative in last June to my knowledge. And finally I should conclude, in fact I have taken too many time, finally I should conclude addressing Chief Guest, Finance Minister Sir, who is the fact custodian and the guardian of our economy, to give us policy support and guidance for development of our capital market with the end in view and ultimate view to develop our economy. Thank you. Thank you for your attention.